Welcome to Home Gourmet. We're here again at the lovely level one of the fabulous Lemon Restaurant with Kolu, who has been in the kitchen with us right throughout and has done some incredible dishes and has got many more lined up. Kolu, what is on the menu today?
Well, today it's all using fruits with meats.
Okay, nice.
That's quite interesting.
Yeah.
We're starting out with a pork curry with apple. Now, when I say pork curry with apples, you know, I'm talking of English European style of curry, not the way we
cook. Right, okay.
So it always find apple and raisins in it, as you can see here.
Yeah.
Get some chopped apple, a bit of flour as your thickening agent, roasted curry powder or garam masala, which can onions, ginger, raisins, lime juice, and garlic.
Great.
And the pork, of course. Some chicken stock.
Okay.
And of course, some oil for frying.
And again, I mean, pork is one of those meats that goes beautifully with sort of apple and raisin and slightly sweet flavors
as
well.
Oh, lovely roast pork with a nice apple sauce is beautiful, no? The raisins thrown, it's great fun. So to begin with this, only as usual, we put some oil into the heated pan.
Yeah.
It's quite easy, you know, this dish. You know, one of the nicest things I like about this curry powder, using this foreign, the international recipe mulagatani.
Right.
Which really actually comes like that with apples and raisins. Have you ever
really
tried it?
No,
it's delicious,
I've never,
man.
Never.
Actually, I must do that for you one day. It's right. Absolutely delicious.
Sounds wonderful.
Yeah.
Right, Kolu, while your oil is heating up, why don't all of you at home take a look at the ingredients?
Pork with apples. 1 pound lean pork diced. 1 tablespoon vegetable oil, 2 apples peeled, cored and chopped, 1/2 cup chopped onion, 2 tablespoons flour, 1 to 2 teaspoons curry powder to taste, 1/4 teaspoon of salt, 1/4 teaspoon of ground ginger, 1/4 teaspoon of garlic powder, 2 cups of chicken broth, 1 tablespoon lemon juice, 1/4 to 1/2 cup golden raisins, optional. Hot cooked rice.
Right, so that oil seems to have heated up quite well.
Heated up well. So now we add the diced pork into this.
Okay. It's sizzling away. Are you all right?
Yeah.
A bit of splatter.
No splatter on me. Sometimes you get some aspects in it, and I'm quite used to the splattering. 28 years or how many? I don't even know. No, mad, more than that. 36 years of cooking, I should be using a lot of splattering. No. So now once I get it browned up nicely, I will add the onion. And the apple into it.
And so, Kolu, when you said earlier this is more of a Western curry, is that obviously because of the fruit and there's no real chili that's...
That's right, because they are very scared to use chili powder. I had the famous story of a friend of mine who went to a hotel school in London.
Yeah.
And she was really not interested in cooking. But when she went in there and they had one of these curries, she was horrified. She said, that's not the way to cook. Then they said, well, since you know so much about curry, you come and cook the curry. So she took all the condiment powders from home and made the whacking chicken curry with chili and roasted curry powder, garlic and ginger. They had a close half day. That's cool. Everyone's stomachs, mouth, everything was burning.
They couldn't handle it.
So once we get this going, now we put the flour here as a thickening agent, as they would say.
Okay.
A little bit of flour. And then with the flour we put some roasted condiment powder.
And the apples are kind of like giving off that slightly caramelized sort of scent.
Very nice.
Lovely.
A little dark in the powder nicely here, the curry, and into this we'll add the ginger.
And so, call it this type of curry, what would you serve it with?
With steamed rice.
Mm-hmm.
Really nice to get this going here, and then into this I'm going to add the stock.
Right.
Now today I'm going to use a secret ingredient, which is quite nice.
Okay.
And that's this, just have a look at this. No Chinese chili recipe mix.
Okay.
That gives a bit of more kick because there's no chili in this.
Yeah.
So I thought we'll add a bit of that. It's a good product from Knorr.
Okay, wonderful.
And, so we can.
So your secret. Koli's secret is out.
It's not my secret, but it's quite nice. And Sunday night, you start to find these things, you know, in the markets. And then you must experiment with them. And I find this is quite a good seasoning or just adding to something like that.
Okay.
So here it's a nice red color, you see, Minoli.
It's that sort of turmeric sort of color almost.
I put a bit of it in, not the whole packet for this quantity.
Okay.
A bit of this. And we'll let it
bubble along.
Bubble along there. So we have our that. I will add our raisins into it.
Oh, wonderful.
I'm going to check for salt later.
Okay.
So we'll let this bubble away. And at the end of this, Minoli, we will then add the lime juice.
Okay.
And you've got a quick, easy
curry.
Pork curry with apple.
Great. And again, this would go nicely with steamed rice. And would you recommend a vegetable with this or not?
Yeah, of course. Nice, you know, some sort of nice greens.
Okay.
Even steamed beans, because you're not really a rice and curry sort of a dish.
Yeah.
Steamed beans or something like that would really complement this.
Okay. Well, that looks great. So while that's bubbling and sizzling away, why don't we take a little break and come back and watch Kolu finish off this dish. So we'll see you soon. That looks pretty much almost done.
Almost done. I'm going to just add the lemon juice or lime juice, whichever one you prefer.
Okay.
You get lovely lemons now in the market.
Yeah.
And that's done, Mino, all ready for you to taste.
Yeah.
With our little secret Chinese hot garlic recipe mix from Knorr.
Which really adds a lot to the dish.
Oh, doesn't it just?
Yeah.
Just a lot of justice to the dish.
Wonderful.
So I'm going to scoop a bit of this for you to taste.
Okay.
And
great, can't wait to get stuck
by
in.
Yourself. It's a nice, well, cold weather, I think these type of dishes are very nice, Minoli.
Yeah.
Morelli or somewhere like that.
Yeah, just kind of sit out in the evening, sort of have dinner on your patio outside.
Yeah. I know. So there is a hot.
Wow. Thank you, Kolu.
Curry for you. A spoon for you to taste. Mm.
I love, you know, and people think it's very strange, but before I eat, I love to just kind of savor the aromas,
of course,
to just
you
kind
must.
Of. But a lot of people look at me like, "Oh my God, what is she
they
doing?"
They think, "Oh, is it a bad smell or has it gone off?" You know.
But I just really, really enjoy taking in all those aromas because I think it really sort of helps your palate actually when
course,
you taste
you know.
It. Yeah, I'm going to let this cool down, but it looks lovely.
Yeah.
And you're right, this is great cold weather food. It's kind of almost got like a stew-like consistency
exactly,
to it.
Exactly, stew-like consistency.
Which is lovely.
Hot, Minoli, so just...
Yeah, it is hot. I think I'm just going to let it cool down while you and I talk.
Yeah.
So, again, Kolu, I mean, you know, this type of dish, it's a Western...
Western-style curry, yes, I've got.
Hmm? Which is interesting. And do you find that a lot of people sort of cook this type of food here, or...?
Here, no, Minoli.
Yeah.
We are all used to our own
curries.
But
yeah.
Actually, when we actually do this and give someone, they enjoy it.
Yeah.
But then we have to change the name. We can't say it's chicken and apple curry.
Yeah.
We say it's apple chicken. Right? Because they think we're mad if we give this as a curry to them, you know? But they like it otherwise, you know?
It's lovely. I love it, Kolu. I love the tangy apple and that slight sweet bit of the raisin. The pork is beautifully
and
good.
And the lime juice at the end.
Gives it that little...
Our pork is excellent. It cooks very well, cooks fast.
Pork is actually one of the best meats, you've always said it, that we have in Sri Lanka. And I love this sauce. The sauce is fabulous.
Fabulous. Huh? Thick with the flour. And of course, our little secret mix with rib inside.
Wonderful.
And next time I'm going to do a fish and pineapple curry.
Oh, really? Wow, that's unusual.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Okay. Another one of Kalu's fabulous secret recipes coming up soon.
Okay.
Well, I've just tasted that wonderful apple and pork curry that Kalu made. And I see you've got some interesting ingredients. You've got fish and pineapple. And tell us a little bit about the next dish.
That's right. Now, the original recipe is this, that it's fish of your choice.
Okay.
Pineapple, which is canned. You can get fresh pineapple here, but I use the canned one because of the syrup.
Right.
Garlic, ginger, onion, some of the juice from the pineapple pieces.
Yeah.
Some saffron, which I've already rubbed into the turmeric, actually.
Okay.
Into the fish and chili powder. You know, this is a very quick, easy recipe. And as you know, fish cooks easily.
Yeah.
Now, you can either take the garlic, ginger, and onion and grind them together.
Okay.
Or use them like that direct. So I prefer to use them direct. So I'm going to use them like that without grinding it. But if you're in a mood, you can
make it into a paste.
Paste and use it.
Okay.
So we just add a little oil into the pan. And then we will
start cooking it. And Kalu, when it comes to cooking fish, it cooks through quite fast.
Yeah.
I mean, you've got to be careful, I guess, that you don't overcook it. What sort of tips would you have for cooking fish?
I have basically, with only cubes this size, I tend to cook on a very high fire.
Right.
So I would just say 3 minutes maximum once the fish is in. So let's start with the onion. Garlic. And ginger.
There's nothing quite like the fragrance of onion in oil, sort of frying in oil.
I know, it's just lovely smell. No?
Yeah.
It's very quick and easy. Now I'm going to do a variation of it because I know you and I both like coconut milk.
Yep.
This says you use just either water or the juice of the pineapple.
Okay.
So I'm going to add coconut milk because it really gives it a really, really nice flavor into this. Okay. So this is the marinated with little turmeric powder.
Mm-hmm.
Put the fish into that. Get that cracking. Now you get all the nice smells, no? The aroma.
Yep, there's hints of turmeric coming
turmeric,
out.
Everything there. Then we put the chili powder into it.
Okay.
You're not such a huge fan of very spicy food, no?
No. I mean, I like a bit of spice, but not too much. It's really weird, I get a headache, so.
Okay, then we try not to give a headache.
It's strange.
Yeah. Then we put the pineapple into this. It's swirling. See, the fish is almost cooked, you know?
Yeah.
It's almost changed color.
Okay. Great, so while that's, while you've got that on the heat, why don't all of you at home take a quick look at the recipe?
And I'm going to add a bit of salt and pepper before we go in the break.
Okay.
Salt and freshly ground pepper. Okay.
Fish curried with pineapple, 300 grams of fish, 200 grams pineapple slices or pineapple juice, 1 onion, 5 to 6 cloves of garlic, a piece of ginger, half a teaspoon turmeric powder, half a teaspoon red chili powder, half a teaspoon freshly ground pepper, salt to taste, oil for frying.
And releasing these like lovely aromas. And it's got a nice color to it as well. It's like
beautiful.
A goldeny.
Yeah, it's a turmeric in it. Okay.
Wow.
And now Minoli.
Yeah.
I put the juice of the canned pineapple into that.
Mm-hmm.
And since we are going to enjoy eating this, now we can either stop it here.
Okay.
Or I am going to be a little naughty and put some of the
coconut
milk into it. It actually really complements this dish.
Yeah. And again, because coconut and pineapple are flavorings that go really well together, it's almost like a sort of pina colada.
Throw in a little Malibu too, huh? Right, so there. Quick, easy pineapple and fish curry.
Yeah.
I'm going to taste it a bit here to check about the salt situation. And then I'm going to give it a taste something.
Yum. And again, fish is something that's really good for you. It's so healthy. And, you know, and we live on an island, so the more fish, I suppose,
and
we eat.
What
the best,
a splendid but, yeah. choice of fish we have here.
Yeah. Mm. Happy?
I'm very happy. It's a bit spicy.
Yum.
You may not be that happy.
I'm sure I'll love it, Kolu.
Uh-huh.
I don't actually think there's anything that you've made that I've not loved.
That's what people ask me, you know. They say, now when you make this, Minora actually enjoy all this. I said, she does. And I hope she, I said, I hope she does, because I said, I'd be very hurt if she actually says it wasn't nice.
That's lovely, Kolu. Actually, everything you've made is wonderful.
Yeah.
And a very good friend of ours was telling me about this wonderful ginger and chocolate cake, apparently, that you used to do.
Well, you know, Minori, I started
doing
my cooking career by doing cakes, you know?
Yeah.
And it's a shame that I have stopped, but I must start again, you know?
Yeah.
Because it's when I started, now it's 30 odd years, and I must get back to it. So probably this year, you know?
Great.
But I want a beautiful oven fight, you know?
Yeah.
Otherwise, you cannot make a nice cake, we will have a nice oven.
Great.
So that's a nice, beautiful curry for you.
Wow.
Which I'm going to give it a taste now.
Yum. Lovely.
Banana. It's over there.
Superb.
Spoon. That's nice.
Yeah. I love that coconut. Coconut and pineapple, such a fabulous combination.
And just very few ingredients.
Yeah. Huh? And fast. It just cooks through so fast. I'm just going to let it cool a little there.
Yeah. I hope you got a bit of pineapple in that. Yeah, I think you
got. So Kolu, again, perfect with just steamed rice, because you don't want to overpower any of the flavors.
I wouldn't like to do anything else.
Yeah.
I know this is a quickly eat when it's cooked. Hot, hot, no?
Yeah. So here we are. But, oh, wow.
Not too hot for you?
Mm-mm.
I was a bit nervous that...
please call
the chili. No, I'm going to take from here.
Nice bit of kick at the back of the throat
back
from
the
chili.
No? And now the next one I'm going to do is a pork curry with mango.
Wow.
Yeah?
I love this whole meat and fruit and fish and fruit. It's wonderful. Yeah. And this, I mean, this is very sort of, you know, it's the kind of thing that you could quickly rustle up for lunch or a quick evening dinner, and it's perfect. And it's just really, really delicious. You must try this at home. So, so good.
Quick, easy.
Quick and easy and fun.
Yeah.
Great. So while Kolu and I sample and snack on this wonderful fish, why don't all of you take a break? But don't forget to join us for the third and final dish of the show. Trust me, it's something you're not going to want to miss, so we'll see you soon. Dish of the show, and again, it looks like it's going to be very interesting. We've got some lovely pork.
Yeah, it's a pork curry with mango.
Okay.
European style. Now, again, you know, this has more ingredients than the last one.
Yeah.
Our fish curry had very few ingredients, simple but very, very tasty.
Yeah.
I absolutely love that dish. So, this is the from the fillet of pork.
Right.
Then we have the raw condiment powder, some cumin, saffron, some new potatoes, chili pieces, garlic, ginger, red bell pepper, tomato puree or paste we can use, chopped tomatoes, onions, mango, and of course some flour, which you're going to open a Ziploc bag.
Okay.
And I'm going to toss the pork into it, and you're going to coat it all nice. It's a very easy way to coat your... And just put all the flour in, you know, and give it a good shake.
Great.
Okay. That's done.
These Ziploc bags are really handy, aren't they?
Oh, you know, it doesn't mess your finger up.
Yeah.
You know, all your fingers are not messed. You just
kind of Nice
and easy, not missing our fingers, nothing.
Wonderful.
So while you're doing that, I have heat in the pan.
Okay, I think it's...
And then...
Quite...
Put the oil into it.
Coat it up there. And Colin, so why, just out of curiosity, why do you need the pork coated in flour? Is that so that it retains...
First, because first you can get it browned evenly.
Okay.
And also because that's an excess thickening agent
for
the curry.
Okay.
Because this is, again, a European style curry. Yeah. So anyway, you see earlier, the first one, we added flour into it. This way, the pork is coated with it. So in order that when you fry it, also it gets a nice coating
evenly.
Evenly on that side.
Super.
So now we have got the oil going there.
Nice and hot.
And now we can nicely toss in the pork. So, oh, it's all nicely coated, see?
Yeah.
There's no waste of anything. We just toss the pork into that.
And let it,
and
crack
let it
a little
fry.
Bit. Great. So while the pork's frying, why don't you take a look at the ingredients?
Pork curried with mango. 2 pork fillets cut into 1-inch cubes. 1 ounce plain flour. 2 tablespoons of oil. 1 red onion peeled and sliced. 2 small red peppers deseeded and sliced. 1 teaspoon turmeric, 1 teaspoon salt, 1 tablespoon curry powder, 1 teaspoon ground cumin, 1 teaspoon ground ginger, 1/2 a teaspoon chili seasoning mix, 4 tomatoes peeled and chopped, 2 teaspoons tomato puree, 3/4 of a pint of chicken stock, 1.5 pounds tiny new potatoes, 2 large mangoes, peeled, stoned, and sliced.
Great, so that's got a nice even coating on it.
Yeah, see what the flour does to it?
Yeah.
It coats the pork nicely. And it's cooking well over there.
Right.
And into this, I'm going to put the onion.
Okay.
And the bell pepper, just pass the bell peppers for me there.
So again, a nice sort of wonderfully coloured dish.
All coloured, beautiful colour, that's right. The red bell peppers are amazing, no minori. Oh, I love the yellow. Yellow is your favourite, no?
I love the yellow. They're just so sweet, you know.
And you get an orange one also, you know.
Okay.
Yeah.
Not half the orange.
I have seen it sometimes here. Now while this is cooking.
What can I pass you?
Right, the turmeric.
Okay.
We get a spoon out here. Turmeric. I'll take a little salt from here.
Yeah.
Okay. Then I'll take the curry powder and the cumin. And I'll give it a nice stir again.
Okay. And now, Colin, I mean, you have hundreds upon thousands of friends. Do they kind of like call you up and ask you to sort of make them their favorite dishes?
I get them to come to the restaurant anyway. I had to be in a mood to have them at home and to cook. So I had some of the chili into that. The garlic.
Yeah.
Now you get all the nice, yummy aroma, no?
All nice bits that are going in there.
Yeah, that's a nice stir. It's a case of adding and stirring them up a bit, you know?
Yeah. And again, like when it comes to things like salt and pepper and stuff, it's to taste, right?
That's
There's no
taste.
Hard and fast.
Yeah, a lot of people are very scared of how they are, very...
careful about.
Using salt. So that's the tomato puree and fresh tomato. Okay. Lots of ingredients on here.
Why use both? Do they kind of give off different flavors or you like to have little pieces of tomato in the?
The tomato puree obviously is much stronger.
More concentrated.
It's more concentrated. And the fresh tomatoes will give that sweetness you need to this.
Okay.
And so will the mango. So now it's all nice over there.
Mm.
And into this,
We'll add the stock.
Okay.
So, and we let it cook nicely.
Right, so that's
all blended very well. And we let it cook
a little bit.
The pork is cooked thoroughly.
Great.
I'm also a great fan of crushed like black pepper. So there goes that.
And just let it sort of simmer away.
I shall taste the salt. Because right at the end, you know, we'll slip in the
mango.
It's all a fruity program today. I'm also getting a bit fruity over here.
Well, it looks lovely and it's sort of sizzling away.
Oh, I've got the potatoes, okay. My dear.
So, I mean, this really is, it's kind of like a meal in itself.
Well, again, like a stew in a different way.
Yeah. Great, well that looks like it's cooking beautifully.
Yes, and as soon as the potatoes are done now,
yeah,
I'll be ready to give it a taste, Minoli.
Great, and I love the, sorry Kolu.
But no, it's quite nice. See the colours are beautiful, red and orange with the mango.
Yeah. I was just going to say, I love the thought of having like these lovely chunks of mango in a curry, it's beautiful.
And now this would be nice if we had some good curry pan.
Gosh, curry pan, don't talk to me about that.
Yeah.
Lashings of butter.
Lashings of butter and curry pang, and this will be nice.
My gosh, yes it would.
So I think that's about ready for you to taste.
So Can't wait.
Just put this aside and scoop some of this lovely pork with the mango into it for you to eat.
Lovely.
See, I didn't cut the mango too small because then it'll look right.
They look beety. You want nice,
nice
big fleshy chunks of it.
Yeah.
Wow.
So that's there. Please try it, Mino.
Yeah. Gosh, Kolu, you spoil me. I think in every show you kind of spoil me with this amazing food. So.
Since you're a big fan of mine, I don't mind spoiling you at all, Mino.
Thank you. Let it cool down there a bit.
Yeah, that's all the problem. It's hot, you know.
Yeah.
But some people love food like that, Minoli. I worked for an ambassador once who just had to have it right there. It was shoveling hot. Yeah, it's amazing. Oh. I'd be terrified to take the food if it was cold.
You've had such an amazing and such an interesting career, Kolu.
Well, if you are willing to do what I'm willing to do, then you can have an interesting career. Because I am live and let live and have a good time, right? So that's why I'm here to Baghdad, the war, Portugal, fantastic time.
How wonderful.
Hot yet?
Oh, God.
I know you had to burn your mouth every time you eat this hot food.
Superb. It's absolutely superb. I love it, Kolu. I really, really love it.
Now we've done two meats and
a fish with
three different kinds of fruits, and they all taste different.
Yeah.
And you know, sometimes the ingredients are almost the same, no?
Yeah. And again, like we've always said, pork is such a versatile meat and it goes beautifully with fruit, you know?
Yeah, beautiful, absolutely. So the first one was with apple, this with pineapple.
With mango. Yeah, the fish,
The fish with pineapple, but the fish in pineapple is good.
And this is lovely.
And the other thing which is very nice with pork, you know, lychees.
Oh, really?
Very nice.
Wow, that's a very unusual combination.
I must do that for you one day, a nice pork with lychees.
Very clever combination. Yeah. Great. Well, I'm going to put this down because we've got to say goodbye. We've come to the end of the show. Kolu, again, thank you. Wonderful, wonderful dishes. Thank you so much.
You're most welcome.
And for everyone at home, we'll be back again next week with some fabulous creations from Kolu, so don't miss the show. And you can log on to our website, which is www.homegourmet.lk. Both Kolu and I love reading the emails and the messages that you send in, so please keep them coming. And we'll be back here again next week. So until then, happy cooking. I've stolen your line.
I wonder if you'll leave that. The potato, even the potato.